We're going to build a circuit that lights up an LED. And if you pay close attention to LEDs, they have one terminal longer than the other. They are asymmetric. The current it goes through them only has one way. So these polarized components, they have this logic symbol as like an arrow. And on the plastic casing, you will see that one of the sides has a flat notch. So if you look at it from top, you will notice that it's flat on one side. That indicates a cathode or where the current wants to flow, where does it get out. One of the terminals is a little longer. And you can say that that longer leg, it's the anode. It's where you are going to apply positive voltage for it to light up. So the LED cannot live alone in our circuit. We need a resistor, and it has that shape, but the logical symbol might be like a rectangular box or a little bit like a zigzag. And we are going to use the letter D of diode for the LED and the R for resistor. And the value of the resistance, maybe we will use 220 ohms this time, but for an LED, it could be between 100 and 1,000 ohms. And on the body of the resistor, you will notice that it has some colors. That is a code to identify the resistor. But we will use the multimeter here. And we are going to set it up in ohms. There's this Greek letter to identify it. And you should set the black terminal of the test leads on COM and the other one in ohms. I think that putting the two test leads on the resistor will have no secrets, but at least as a reminder, maybe some of us won't have an auto-ranging multimeter. So when you select ohms, you need to also choose how big the resistor is. So for this case, I will use 600 or 6,000. If I choose another value, it doesn't matter, but I will not be able to see the value. When I'm not touching anything, the test lead shows OL of over limit. Now I connected correctly. It shows 218, very close to 220 ohms. And of course, we will need to connect this LED to a power supply. I will put it in red color and address it with a plus. Also, a ground or a negative terminal. So I will use the letters G and D, and I will use this color to represent the cables that are connecting the components. And for that, we will use the breadboard. You will notice that in the main part of the breadboard, A to E are all together. There's a slot, there's a gap, and then F to J are all together again. That means that they are electrically connected. And also on the sides, there are red and blue power rails. So I tear this into parts so you can take a look at how does this work. The camera is not super perfect, but I think that you get the idea. The connections you are going to making is, for example, when we say that the LED goes to ground, we'll connect it to the power rail identified with blue and the minus. And the LED, I bend the terminals and I insert it to the positive power rail. And we can see G and D on the bottom of Arduino Nano on both sides. And there's one pin here, the second one from the top, that says 3.3 volts. When I flip it, I can put the Arduino Nano into the breadboard. And I have to press firmly, but also still being careful of not bending the headers. I should connect ground to the pin identified with white color, and I can put it anywhere along the rail I chose as negative, as labeled as blue. From there, I go to the LED, and the LED to the resistor, and resistor, we still need one more connection. So let's confirm the diagram. Every of these points were connected. I still have one missing. So I will connect along the red anywhere, but now I have to choose the second pin on the left from the USB micro to be able to get the power from Arduino. So I still don't know too much about the voltage, but we are going to test that right now. So now the on of the Nano lights up, but the other LED doesn't. So I use the multimeter in the V with a straight line indicating voltage of the right current, VDC. So I realized that, first of all, I had a pin incorrectly. After that, I see the 3.3 almost, and now we know why it's IoT Nano 33. And the 3.3 volts is coming from the pin 2, that's correct. Nevertheless, my LED doesn't light up. I'll replace it, and yeah, that's it. Now I have light.